Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the femoral triangle and the swellings in the femoral triangle. So I will talk about the position of the triangle, the boundaries, the roof, the floor, the contents, and swelling in the femoral triangle. Okay. So regarding the position of the femoral triangle, it is located in the front of the upper third of the thigh. Regarding the boundaries, okay, the medial wall is the medial border of the adductor longus muscle. This is the adductor longus muscle. The lateral border is the medial border of the sartorius muscle. This is the sartorius muscle. The base of the triangle is the inguinal ligament. The apex is the meeting of the sartorius and the adductor longus. The roof, skin, superficial fascia, and the deep fascia. The superficial fascia contains the great saphenous vein, this one, and the superficial branches or cutaneous branches of the femoral nerve. The deep fascia contains this opening, the saphenous opening. Regarding the floor, it is formed of muscles from medial to lateral. The first one is the adductor longus muscle, then pectineus, psoas major muscle, and iliacus muscle. Again, the medial border of the triangle is the medial border of the adductor longus. The lateral border of the triangle is the medial border of the sartorius. The base is the inguinal ligament. The apex is the meeting of the sartorius and the adductor longus. The roof, skin, and the fascia. Superficial fascia contains the great saphenous vein and cutaneous branches of the femoral nerve. And the deep fascia contains the saphenous opening. Regarding the floor, it's formed of four muscles from medial to lateral. Number one is the adductor longus, then pectineus, psoas major muscle, and iliacus. Regarding the contents of the femoral triangle, the first content is this sheath, the femoral sheath, which surrounds the upper 1.5 inches of the femoral vessels. Then femoral vessels. Femoral artery and its branches, and then femoral vein and its tributaries. The femoral vein is medial. The femoral artery is lateral. Then nerves. The first one and the largest one is the femoral nerve, which is lateral to the artery. And then a small nerve lateral to the femoral artery, which is the femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve, and a plexus around the femoral artery, sympathetic plexus around the femoral artery. Remember, vein, artery, nerve, from medial to lateral. The most medial is the femoral vein, the most lateral is the femoral nerve, and in the middle, the femoral artery. And deep inguinal lymph nodes. So the contents: femoral sheath, femoral vessels, femoral artery and the femoral vein, nerves, femoral nerve, femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve, sympathetic plexus around the femoral artery, and then deep inguinal lymph nodes. Start by the femoral sheath. This is the femoral sheath. It is a fascial sheath around the upper 1.5 inches of the femoral vessels. Regarding the walls, it has anterior wall and the posterior wall. The anterior wall is extension from transversalis fascia of the anterior abdominal wall. The posterior wall is extension from iliacus fascia of the posterior abdominal wall. So this is transversalis fascia, and this is iliacus fascia, or fascia transversalis and fascia iliaca. Regarding compartments, it is divided into three compartments by two septa. The lateral compartment contains the femoral artery and the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. This is the femoral artery. This is the femoral artery, and this nerve is the femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve. The middle compartment contains the femoral vein. Femoral vein, femoral vein, middle compartment. And the medial compartment is called the femoral canal. So this is the femoral canal, the medial compartment of the femoral sheath. The femoral nerve lies outside the femoral sheath. Again, femoral sheath, walls and compartments. This is the inguinal ligament. This is the lacunar ligament. This is the femoral nerve. The anterior wall of the femoral sheath is the continuation of the transversalis fascia of the anterior abdominal wall. The posterior wall is extension of iliacus fascia of the posterior abdominal wall. It is divided into three compartments by two septa. The lateral compartment, femoral artery, and the femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve. The middle compartment contains femoral vein, and the medial compartment is called the femoral canal. The upper end of the femoral canal is called the femoral ring. This is the femoral ring, and it is closed by fat called the femoral septum, and it contains a lymph node, deep inguinal lymph node, one of the deep inguinal lymph nodes. Regarding the femoral canal, this is the femoral canal. So what is the femoral canal? It is the medial compartment of the femoral sheath. The upper end of the femoral canal is called femoral ring. This femoral ring is closed by femoral septum. And the femoral septum, okay, which closes the femoral canal, okay. Regarding the boundaries of the femoral ring, anterior border is the inguinal ligament. Posterior border is the pectineal ligament. Medial border is the lacunar ligament. And the lateral border, okay, is the femoral vein. Actually, the femoral canal, inferiorly, it is closed by blending of its walls. And medially, it is closed by blending of its walls. This femoral canal contains a lymph node. This is the lymph node, one of the deep inguinal lymph nodes. The advantage of the femoral canal, it allows distension of the femoral vein during muscular exercise to increase the venous return. The disadvantage of the femoral canal, it gives a passage to femoral hernia. This is the femoral hernia passing through the femoral canal. And this is a large femoral hernia. Okay, so the femoral canal is the medial compartment of the femoral sheath. The upper end is called the femoral ring. It is closed by femoral septum. It is bounded anteriorly by the inguinal ligament, posteriorly by the pectineal ligament, medially by the lacunar ligament, and laterally by the femoral vein. It allows distension of the femoral vein. It gives a passage to femoral hernia. Regarding the femoral hernia, this is femoral hernia passing through the femoral canal. So the femoral hernia is medial to the femoral vein. Is it more common in males or in females? It is more common in females than in males. Why? Because the female pelvis is wider than the male pelvis, and the femoral canal is wider in the females than in the males. Regarding the femoral artery and its branches, it is the continuation of the external iliac artery at the deep inguinal ring. It leaves the femoral triangle at its apex. In the femoral triangle, it gives the following branches. 3 superficial inguinal arteries. The 3 superficial inguinal arteries are this one, the first one, is the superficial external pudendal artery. And the number 2 is the superficial epigastric artery. And the number 3 is the superficial circumflex iliac artery. Second branch, okay, so this is the superficial external pudendal artery. This is the superficial epigastric artery. And this is the superficial circumflex iliac artery. Okay, so 3 superficial inguinal arteries. And then this artery, which is the deep external pudendal artery, and the largest branch of the femoral artery is the profunda femoris artery, and its branches, medial circumflex and the lateral circumflex femoral arteries, and of course, muscular branches. The femoral artery has another branch, but in the adductor canal. It's called the descending genicular artery. Regarding swelling in the femoral triangle. Swelling in the femoral triangle is from any of the contents. So if you remember the contents of the femoral triangle, you can expect any swelling. So what are the contents and the related swelling? The first content, femoral artery. So femoral artery aneurysm, dilatation. Localized dilatation of the femoral artery due to weakness of the wall. Femoral vein thrombosis or deep venous thrombosis. Okay, femoral canal, femoral hernia. Okay, how about the inguinal lymph nodes, enlarged inguinal lymph nodes, either by inflammation or by tumor. The floor contains psoas muscle. Psoas abscess. This psoas abscess is between the fascia and the muscle. It extends from the abdomen to the femoral triangle. And finally, lipoma of the fatty tissue of the superficial fascia. So what are the swellings in the femoral triangle? The first one, femoral artery aneurysm. It is a pulsating swelling due to dilatation of the femoral artery, okay, due to weakness of the wall of the femoral artery. Regarding the vein, femoral vein, okay, so femoral vein thrombosis, deep vein thrombosis, okay, femoral canal, femoral hernia. This is the femoral hernia. This is the femoral hernia passing through the femoral canal, so it lies below the inguinal ligament, lies below the inguinal ligament, unlike the inguinal hernia, which lies above the inguinal ligament. Okay, how about the lymph node? Okay, enlarged inguinal lymph nodes, whether superficial or deep. Okay, this is psoas abscess. Psoas abscess. Abscess between the muscle and the fascia, and this abscess extends into the femoral triangle. How about the fatty tissue? Okay, so lipoma, benign tumor of the fatty tissue. And thank you very much, best wishes, and good luck.